Well, hello everyone, I'm Yanni from BUVU Gaming, and today we are back in Banished. Yes, at long last. I'm sorry about me kind of abandoning my last few series that I had on this. I had like three different series going, but I think I kind of burned myself out on the game. I played so much Banished last year. It was the first game on my channel, and I played several different mods, and I participated in the Banished Challenge, both the Banished Challenge series, and I don't know, I think I just suddenly had enough. It wasn't really intended, but I just didn't really get back to it, and lately I've just been thinking about it, that I kind of wanted to get back into Banished. I don't know, maybe I'll pick up one of those series, or two of those series, or something. The North mod has been updated since, so I would probably start a new one if I want to get back into that one. Maritimes, technically I could continue with that, but I haven't checked out if there has been any changes. I'll have to check and see if those mods have been updated. They are not on Steam though, so it's kind of your own choice if you want to update them or not, since they are available on Black Liquid's website. And then there's the megamod series. I could just choose to try and continue that, but we'll see. But the idea with this one is that RedKetchup actually has made like an editor's choice modpack that contains all of his like favorite mods that he would like to play, that he has made, and he has also added a lot of new stuff to this one. So that is the mod pack, as you can see here, RedKetchup Editor's Choice Full Version 1, which was just released on Steam this week. I thought we should try that one out and just see what it's all about. Actually, Kendi64 has been talking about this for the last couple of months. We are kind of in a Discord group together, Discord server together, so I've seen her mention it a few times, and I think she actually has a series on it on her channel, so you can always go and check that out. I don't know if she's gonna start a new one now that the game is on Steam, because she has been playing the version that is available, well, has been available from elsewhere. But let's just see. We're gonna say new. And Skokomo, Deriton, Holtonita. Yeah, let's just go with that and pick some random seed. There we go. And then we have all these different types of terrain sizes that we can choose from. All these peaks, valleys, grid, peaks, plains, grid. I just want to go with peaks, lakes, I think. And then we have terrain size, very large, climate fair, disaster zone. Starting conditions hard is usually the one I choose, but there are a few other options in this one. There's hard alternate, in which you have 4 families, 12 tools, 20 cloth, 1200 firewood, 100 firewood, 1200 food, and 100 firewood. No building materials, 1 seed, and no livestock. So you actually have 1 seed on like the normal hard version. There's gatherers, in which one you have actually less food. Only 3 families, 12 tools, 12 cloth, 800 food, 80 firewood, and you have no seeds or anything. Okay. There's a shepherd, which has 2 livestocks. And there's a farmer that has 3 crop seeds, but no livestock. But I kind of just like starting with the hard one. And yeah, let's just say okay. And as usual, let's just start with hitting space. And then we're gonna need to get some of our windows up here. There we go. So we have a professions list. We have our little event log. Let's put you down here. We're gonna put you down here. We have a little map here. Oh wow, there's a lot of lakes on this one. Okay, well that's cool, and we're kind of right in the middle of everything. Aha, so we have our big river coming down here. So my suspicion would be that the trader will be coming from over here and kind of down through the river, so somewhere over here might be a good place, or up here, to build some trade stations or something at some point. And what else? Then of course we have our overview of resources here, and we are gonna look at our limits for a second. And let's just increase this, this. Fuel, let's leave you for now. Minerals, textiles, leave all that. Food, I always tend to just max that out. Herbs, yeah, that's fine. Leave that a little, or increase that a little bit. Okay, we can always look at them more later. Okay, and then we have all our resources. We have our professions. Awesome. So what are we gonna do? As you can see, there's also, with this mod pack, there's changes to the map. So this looks very different. There's different kind of resources. Like gold or something? I have no idea. I think this is iron ore. I don't know if this is copper. I haven't watched any videos on this. I actually did try and start a game of this. I was recording another video earlier today, but ran into some issues, which I'm gonna tell you about in a little while. Oh, look at that, we have bears on the map. But yeah, there's new kinds of crops, there's new animals on the map, there's new buildings. All the vanilla buildings have been remodeled, as you can see here, the wooden houses. So there won't be the normal vanilla buildings are not in here. The same for the stone ones. Look at that, they look completely different now. Even the boarding house has been remodeled, so everything kind of fits nicely together. And then you can just kind of go through all of these things. We have a storage barn, very nice. We have stockpiles, we have a market. See, it has gotten new roofs and everything. Yep, and our trading post, everything has gotten these fancy new brown roofs. There we go. Okay, and then over here we have all of RedKetchups' additions here. So we have a lot of different houses. We'll get more into all of this. We have some roads. We have like storage and market and everything. We have various stockpiles here, and this is actually what got me into trouble. Because usually what I would do in the beginning, I used to just take the vanilla stockpile, but I had started actually doing this where I choose to have these individual stockpiles. So I would have one for wood, and then I would put one for stone, one for iron, for instance, and let's say one for firewood out here. Instead of having one big stockpile, because usually in the beginning those are just the resources that you need to build, and then you kind of later on, as you get all the other buildings in, you'll start needing other kinds of stockpiles. But this kind of got me into trouble, because when you place down buildings and they cut down trees, suddenly you will have new resources that don't fit in here and they can't put them in here. So it is a very good idea to put down just a normal vanilla stockpile, or all the other different stockpiles, but I am just gonna go for the vanilla one. And let's just put that out here. Oh, that was not quite as long as I wanted it to be. Let's just, that was not the one, this one. There we go. Yep, it's been a while. It's been a while. I think it's been almost 6 months since I played this, actually. And there we go. Now we have a vanilla stockpile that should carry everything. So in case there's something that can't go in here, then it can go in here. For instance, this one that is iron, that is actually seems to be actual iron, like finished burned iron and not the iron ore. So we are gonna need this anyway. Anyway, we are gonna need, oh, there's also something there. It looks like it might be silver or something. And yeah, I actually got the reply from RedKetchup about this thing with the stockpiles, and got into the game, and I got them to actually put the stuff in here, but then the game seemed to be a little bugged for me because they refused to build the house or the buildings, so I decided to start a new game. But let's see, I would like a gatherer's hut somewhere. Let's just take a little look at this map. Might be nice to do some mining over here. Okay, where would be a good place? Well, there's a lot of trees over here. That would be a good place for a forester. And we'll kind of gather it too. There's so many resources on the maps in general. Like, so much iron and stone and, yeah, all kinds of stuff. I think we're gonna put you down here somewhere. Let's put you... Right there, we're gonna have a gatherer's hut right there. Then we are gonna get a hunter too. See where did I place it? I placed it right there. Do we have any animals? Well, we had some bears, but do we have any animals in this area? Or do I want to place my hunter somewhere else? That doesn't mean that they won't be moving into this area, but I'm actually not really seeing any animals, so it might not be the best place for a hunter. Where were those bears? They were over here. Okay, let's wait with that and start with our gatherer, and then of course I would also like a forester's lodge. See, that has gotten the new fancy roofs too, and the same has the gatherer's hut. Okay, where are you? In here somewhere. Yep. Okay, so 1, 2. Let's give them a little room, shouldn't we? Yep, we're gonna do that. There we go. We're gonna put you there. We're gonna pause you. Okay, so we have gatherer's hut. We're not too far away from the water though, because usually I would like to actually start with a fisherman, but it's always a little bad if they have to walk too far with that, but it's kind of a nice little spot out here that I kind of like, if I can get it to fit, that is. Just being obnoxious. Come on. Won't do it. Okay, you'll do it over here. Not exactly what I wanted, but for those who don't know, you just hit... Okay, that would might be an option. On this side. Yeah. You hit R to rotate your buildings, and if there are more versions, like, of the houses, you use the F key. And there we go. Okay, we're gonna have a fisherman. Okay, so if we have the gatherer there, we are gonna have... we'll have our stockpiles over there. That's not the most handy thing. Where do we want to have our town? Let's see. We do have all of this. We have the river going here. Well, they're not gonna come down that way. We're gonna have them coming down. Okay, so I'd probably like my town to kind of move up in this direction so we can get some trading going at some point. But it is not the worst location, this one. But I'm gonna want a house over here. I'm just thinking if I should move my stockpiles a little bit, but let's see, it's probably okay with this gatherer for starters. And then we can put in a hunter too. So we have our stockpiles, let's tell them to actually collect some resources. So I would want them to collect some trees, but I don't really want to cut these trees down because I want to leave them for the forester. So let's just try and cut some stuff over here. We're gonna need some stone. Let's just take the stone right there. We are gonna need... Let's get a little bit of iron ore. Maybe from this area in here, just in case we need it. And yeah, let's go. Gonna speed it up a little bit. Let's make sure we have a couple of builders. I seem to recall that it was the laborers that were cutting down stuff. Or, you know, on these places, like the trees. But it appears to be the builders. I just seem to recall it was the laborers who would actually cut down stuff and move resources, and then the builders would build the buildings. But here it seems like it has to be the builders that actually do this stuff. Okay, there we go. Now we have the gatherer's hut. Are you guys gonna bring some resources over here? Hopefully. Please don't bug out. Yep, they're bringing resources. Awesome, and that little pause is just because the game is set to save, and you can change that in the settings if you wanted to save less frequently or more frequently or something. Okay, they are doing what they're supposed to do. Awesome, let's see. I also want... I'm gonna need a woodcutter. There we go, look at that. He's also got this nice little roof. I think this is where I put my... firewood. So let's see, that's gonna be over here. We'll probably have a road going out here somehow. Oh, that's fine. Let's just oh, we could just put you right across there from the firewood. Let's do that. Nice. Okay, so we can start getting some food, because we only have 16 people actually. And we only have 1200 food, and for those who don't know, the general standard is that you need 100 food per citizen per year. So we don't actually have enough to feed all these people for a year. How are we doing? 30 logs. Oh, we need a little bit more stone. We do have a little stone here. Oh, there we go. They went and got the stone. And let's just make sure to... Oh, that was true. Next. Oh, they were already assigned, I guess. Yeah, they're already assigned. They're just being a little slow with it. Okay, how are we doing? 8 out of 12. Well, we also have this one. Please work on that. Let's do this so we have enough builders for both places. Two there, awesome. Oh, I have to remember there's a fisherman too. I kind of forgot to pause that, but okay. They are kind of finishing that off too. Well, let's look at the housing. Of course, we have these wooden houses and stone houses. Then we have all kinds of houses in here. We have country little house, toolbar. You guys might remember these. They have got new roofs too. Well, these are different actually. Huh. I just remember the one with the yellow. Uh-huh. Country little pantry. Well, the version I've seen only has the yellow house. Okay, that's cool. And we have country little house, which has... Oh, house 2. Okay, so this is a different one. Interesting. Nice. What kind of resources do we need? We need lumber for that, so that's not what we're gonna go for. Colorful little house. This is the one I was actually thinking about. There we go. Look at that one. And that one has like a second story. And yes, with the F key, you can change the colors. Then, what do you need? Let's... Oh. Okay, this one we could technically build. 24 wood and some stone. We have Boston houses, but we're gonna need glass and all that stuff for it. But they are in different colors, as you can see. Boston house 2. Nice. And what is this? NMT little house toolbar. Oh, I'm sorry about that. I've got a cat going crazy in the background right now. I don't know what's up with Bastion.
Yeah, that's good. Aww.
He's found a little mouse. And he's just telling me about it. Well, it's a toy mouse, but... because they're indoor kitties. Oh, nice. We have all these versions. Very cool, but we are needing some resources we don't have. Move you up. Oh boy, there's so many. Look at all these. Oh yes, we are gonna play around with all of this, but we're gonna need a ton of different resources. So the only thing we actually can build is these. 24 wood and 6 stone at the moment anyway. Or the wooden houses. 16 wood and 8. Stone. That might be a nice cheap one. There's also the stone house one. No, we're gonna go with the wooden houses. Yep. Okay, well, we're gonna wonder who... Ooh, house over here where we have our woodcutter. He would like a house, I am sure. Should we put it right next to him? Or do we want to have it like a little... So we get like a little square thing going here. Let's see. Oh, I really like the look of all these. Okay, so this is kind of like a little side. Oh, I actually should look at that because I chose to give them extra space. So we're gonna come out here. Yeah, okay, because you could choose to make wider roads or something. Yeah, I think let's just put you over there. We're gonna start building a house. Okay, and how are we doing? Almost done with the fishing docks. They just need to build it. Woodcutter, of course, we're not really... They've removed it. They need a little bit of stone. God, this hut is almost getting built. Okay. Come on. I'm so gonna fail at this. It's been such a long time since I played. It's amazing how fast you forget all this stuff. Oh, we can only have one working in... Oh, no, we can have more. Okay, let's just get some people in here. We have max 4 people. I am just gonna put 3 people in here right off the bat so they can start working. At the moment though, they will have to put all their resources over here, so you definitely need some storage. Let's see, what kind of storage do we have? We have a little storage barn. Well, it's actually a fairly big storage barn, look at that. Or... what if we go in here? Storage. Ooh, there's a ton of stuff here. Normal barn, you can see how much it takes. Used to store goods such as food, clothes, textiles, and tools. 7,500 weight capacity. Okay, medium, 5,500. Small barn, 4,000. Tiny barn, 2,000. See, that's just a tiny, tiny one like this. Granary is specialized storage used to store only food. That might be something I would want out by the gatherway. It is just so big. It is so big. Oh, then there's the fodder. Garden walls, fodder barn. Barn that only allow fodder items and everything that fall into that category. Oh my, look at this, guys. Oh, that is cool. And then we have a forest barn. Okay, what do you do? Can store everything that can come from forest outposts. So that so is that include wood and stuff too? Or what do we mean by forest outposts? Like, this is what I consider a forest outpost. But okay, let's try and use that. Let's try that. So we have our wood cutter over our forest over here. We have our gatherer right here. And let's do it as a little... do we want to give them a little extra space? Yeah, we're going to do that. And... okay, that's our forest barn. Okay, now we have our gatherer. And let's click on this. They have started gathering some berries. Let's just put you here so we can see if they actually collect something. Because we have food. Okay, then we have the woodcutter. They should start building that. Fishing dock. Ooh, almost done. Actually, before we do anything. Oh, wow. My head is all over the place. Okay, this dirt road might start with that. Just for them to work a little faster. So we have 1, 2, 3. I did put 3 between them here. So, yep, there we go. Do this. I just wanna bring it over here somewhere. Oh, wait, ooh, I think there maybe. Hopefully that was correct. Yeah, that looks about right. That looks about right. And see, then we would have a road going down here. Where do you meet up? Of course they're gonna have to work on this. Ooh, I can't see a thing. Oh, it's actually right here. Okay, so there we go. And then in front of this house. There we go. That's just a little beginning road there. And these are gonna be, yep, done. Fishing dock. We're definitely gonna need some storage over here too, but let's just put some people in here. There we go, so they can start fishing. So what do we have? Let's bring this down. So we have 2 builders available. They will be working on, they should be working on a woodcutter. Okay, we got a forest barn. Okay, yeah, let them just finish that. That is high priority. And then we would like something out here, actually. Oh, I haven't. Oh, there's the house. Keep forgetting to keep them here. Okay, that's almost done too. So they will have a house by the time we enter autumn. That is good. And I am gonna want to have a house over here too. So let's just... oh, there we go. Let's get this guy. No, for right now I just want one. There we go. Let's bring up the... limit a little bit, then we can make firewood from 2 logs, firewood from lumber, and firewood from fodder thatch. Yes, we're gonna go do it from log now. How much do we have? We actually don't have any resources. Let's work on that. Let's get you to cut down some trees out here and out here. Maybe in this area. Yep, you're gonna be busy. And let's get a little bit more stone. How are we doing in that? We don't have a lot. Okay, we're gonna want to clear out stone in here so that once we get the forester going, then there won't be all of this stone blocking spots where we could have trees growing. I think actually all of this stuff is something you can remove too. Collect flowers. Let's just see, can we find... Oh, there's flowers there. Oh, look at that. We can collect flowers. Then we can collect fodder. I think this would be fodder. Yeah. Okay, let's just let them get a little bit of that. Collect wild food. Okay. There's a little bit there. Just a single. Not a lot, but you can get them to collect some. Collect copper. Okay. I have a feeling this is... Yes, that's copper. What is it? Collect deadwood. Collect all deadwood in a selected area for firewood. Okay, that could be handy. There's not a lot of it, though, but there's a little bit. Okay. There we go, a little bit of firewood. And then there's iron ore. There's almost all. Collect all ores and trees in a selected area. So I guess no stone, maybe? Okay, so the fisherman and the fisherman has grown in, moved in here. That's not exactly what we would want. We would kind of like them to live out here. But there's no room or no house out here yet. So, let's see. Yeah, we're gonna have... So, do we want them to walk through here? I'm kind of thinking we might want that. Yeah, that's our road. Our road is here. So we kind of just try and bring it out in this direction a bit. And where's our fisherman? And no, don't want a coast thing going there. But let's do a little road in front here. Do a little thing there. And let's just see how far can we bring you to here. And then maybe we can fit something right here. And let's just bring you up a little bit in and then bring you over. See how far I think that actually matches. Yeah, that means my builders are probably going to be busy working on that. Okay, we have fishermen. We are going to need a storage or something out here. So, what do we want to use for you? I do have a root cellar, a specialized underground storage used to store only fruit and vegetables, so that can also be handy for the gatherer, for instance. For the barn, forest barn, so it doesn't seem like we have one specifically for fish, which you sometimes do in certain... Ooh, there's all these little stores. Look at that, grocery store, a raw materials store, supplies and goods, building materials, got a market. Nice. And we have all these little cart. It's a specialized mini market as big as a cart. Look at that. Then you can kind of make your own little market out of that with all these little carts. But ooh, there's also decorations. Haha, there's trees, there's fences, and other fences. Oh, these are ghosted. Okay. We will look into that later. I'm sure I'm gonna get myself lost in that. Then there's the canal set. Two. Look at all this stuff that you can play around with. Wow, look at that. Yep. So many things. That's a different look. Yes, okay, that's not something to play around with now. I kind of want to get more into the game first. What are we going to do with storage for you guys then? Tiny, you are a little tiny. Small, maybe? Would be a good fit. The granary, only for food. But it is a big building. I am tempted to put one out here though, because I could imagine us getting more stuff going on here, and then we have a bigger storage here as well as in town, because it's gonna fill up very fast. These smaller buildings, I intend to do that, so Yeah, we're gonna build a granary. It is a little expensive and it is a fairly big building. We're also gonna need housing out here, of course. So, let's check that out. Wooden house, can I fit you here? It just can't fit. Nope. Just isn't room. Okay, let's just see. If I want it a little there, then it's just that little corner. Well, there should be... canal, is it in here? Flat tool serves to flat the ground back to normal after deleting a canal. That's not really what I want. But there should be some options for terraforming. I am just not seeing them right now. Be any of these. It said something about there being 6 different terraforming options or something along those lines. Okay. What if I try to do this? Gonna do anything? Oh, it is. Let's just try this out. And there we go. And will you then let me build this house? Nope, that's not the right place that I flattened, so let's just do this. There we go. I try and do that. And then we are gonna go here. Can I get my... See, now I can get a little house in here. Hey, sneaky. Yep, okay, so which one are we gonna pick? Which one, guys? I kind of like this one for this place, I think. Or this one. Yeah, let's go for that one. Yep, we're gonna have this house here. Of course, now it bugs me that I have this flattened area. But I don't think there's any way of kind of fixing it again. So now we just have this strange little thing sticking out here. I'll have to look that up because it did say something in the description that there's supposed to be some more options. But I am not sure where those would be hidden. Because they should be over here. After deleting a canal piece, a pond, or an open sky mine. Yeah, okay. But as you can see, you can use it for this. You just have to make sure that you use it at the right spot. Okay. Yep, you're busy fishing. We are gonna... How are we doing? We're down to 500 food. That's not so good. But we are getting some stuff from our gatherers here. How many people do we have? We have 2 laborers and 2 builders. And we've got the fisherman living in this wooden house. Not exactly what I would want. Woodcutter, you still don't have any logs. Well, laborers should cut down some trees soon. There we go, and bring them over here. And as you can see, the iron ore is actually going into the vanilla stockpile. But that is, this is exactly why, yeah, that's why they're not really building right now. They're prioritizing the roads. This is why I like to have separate stockpiles, because this can easily fill up with wood or something, because they put it in this as a priority. They will use the vanilla stockpile over any other stockpile. So they will very often put... Okay, now they actually put the wood here. Okay, that's cool, because very often, previously I've noticed that when playing modded versions, they would put everything into the vanilla stockpiles and ignore all the specialized stockpiles. Which is a little frustrating when you want them to actually use this. Or the same with storages, they would put everything into general storage and ignore any specialized storages. Okay, woodcutter is working now, so we should get some firewood going. Awesome. Our forest barn is done. So they should start, there we go, working on that. Awesome. I do want to get that forester's lodge going, but beforehand I would kind of like for them to maybe prioritize this little priority tool here, this granary out here. Of course the housing too, but we need the food. At least the food is going up a little bit. We're up to 736 now. That is good. Okay, we have firewood and roots in the first ban. I'm just kind of curious as to what goes into this one. They are collecting a lot of food, but I'm not really seeing much of it end up in here. There's a lot of stuff over here though, but they do move it, as you can see in here. There's firewood, potatoes, and roots. That's the first thing they will do. You will often see this drop, for instance, right after finish building a house. Then suddenly this will take a drop, because they will kind of hoard some stuff and put it into their own storage. Yeah, they're going over there with the fish now to... Okay, how are we doing here? 246 fish. Hmm. Okay, 100, 200, 300, 400, 5, 6, 7, about 700 food or something. And plus 200. Well, so far we are definitely not producing enough to feed all these people. Let's see, we do have 3 laborers, 2 builders. Okay, I think we are gonna put one more in here because they're closest to the storage. So let's do that. It's gonna be autumn though. But we do have one house. It would just be nice to get this house also done soon. Yep, okay. We could need some more resources, I think. So let's plant some more trees out here. And oh, they are actually all assigned. They are just very busy. And so far they only have one house where they can go and get warm, which is what they will do even if it's not their house. Then yeah, you can see late autumn we're getting snow, but they should all go here and warm up. When they feel cold, then they'll go in here and get warm. And hopefully that is also how it works in this mod. Look at this one. Okay. What are we doing? I should put you over here too. Sorry about that. I'm losing my voice suddenly. a little bit more stone might be a good idea. I'm just trying not to overdo it with the collection here. You know what? Let's do pause for a second. And let's just put a little vanilla stockpile down here. There we go. So they might bring some stuff down here instead of having to go all the way home with it, for instance, with the stone. And we can cut down a... I kind of like to leave some of these houses. Or trees there, actually. There we go. Someone left a fish right there in the middle of nowhere. Okay, well, we have 1,300 food now, so that is good. The season hasn't ended yet. I'm quite curious to see what we are gonna end up with numbers. And as you can see, sometimes the fishermen will go and do something else, so they picked up some berries somewhere along the way. Okay, so far no one is freezing, so that is good. Okay, well, we are kind of out of time for this time, guys. I am quite curious to see how it's gonna go with this this series. Oh, we got a child, actually. Nice, a child named Sanderson was born. That's another reason why we're gonna need some more housing so we can get more people. But I do wanna be sure that we have enough food production that we can actually handle more people. So, because every time we make a house, there's always a chance that they are gonna have kids. And, well, these have 3 children, and if I remember correctly, they can only have 5. Oh, they don't have a lot of food in here. They can only have 5 people in their wooden houses, if I remember correctly. It doesn't actually say here, but if I... Yeah. So they will not get any more kids, but if we build another house and we only have 2 people moving in there, they might have more kids, or have 3 kids all of a sudden over the next couple of years. So it's a good idea to kind of limit your house building a little bit, but not too much. It's kind of the balance in the game. that you... oh, nice, this is getting built. That you have to find the right balance between how fast you build houses and, you know, keep an eye on the food, but also don't build, you know, don't build the houses too fast because you'll have too many baby booms. And then suddenly you'll run out of food. But at the same time, if you build too slowly, your people will start growing up and dying, or growing old and dying, and then you'll suddenly start running out of people. So it's very much a balanced thing. Anyway, thank you for watching, guys, and as always, do take care and happy gaming!